Los Angeles has its art photography fair and exposition, its Photo LA. The event has gathered for over 21 years more than 300 galleries, private dealers, and publishers from all around the world. It's a key event in the LA art life for collectors, curators, dealers, and all people interested into photography. For the past 2 years, Photo LA has also invited the Blind Photographer's Guild. This year, they present the works of Alice Wingwall, Bruce Hall, and Pete Eckert. If Alice Wingwall has lost her sight years ago, she remains a vital visual artist.
Photography used the recording quality of the camera, but I wanted to make compositions that were not just what I saw in front of me, and eventually what I didn't see in front of me. So I would just choose from a big composition that I imagine exists out here, and I could photograph that. So recently, I got a sweep panoramic camera. This camera has to move through space from left to right, and it takes 6 images and stitches them together.
Alice works with the juxtaposition of images, bringing together compositional elements, memories, and associations. She's also a sculptor, and she does try to recreate, whether it's in 3 dimensions or in photography, her own experience of vision.
Every photograph anyway just starts in your mind, in your brain, and you make the decision. And you decide what you're going to put in the composition. And even if I can't see through a viewfinder, I'm going to decide what's in there.
When most photographers see in order to photograph, Bruce Hall photographs in order to see. He has constructed his world from photographs. Bruce is almost blind, and he has learned to overpass all barriers like scuba diving. Bruce is a well-known underwater photographer. Last year, the Playboy magazine has asked both he and Pete Eckert to make a series of nude photographs in Hollywood.
I also am currently working on a project with my wife. Our twin sons have profoundly autistic. About 3 years ago, I realized that I couldn't pose them. They wouldn't hold still long enough, ever. These aren't the kind of boys that can sit down and take a picture of them. So I changed everything and just got into their space, followed their lead, and the magic, that's when the magic started happening. It was great. Showed here 3 years ago, and last year. Had the curator of photography for the Library of Congress tell me that this is a fabulous project, and they purchased a portfolio for the permanent collection. I'm fortunate to have that little bit of being able to see it at about 3. It's about 3.5 inches. You know, I've measured it. I've taken a tape measure from my eye and measured it. And at about 3.5 inches, I can see detail. So if I get up to the picture, like, if I get about this close, I can see the detail. So I will sort of study the image and then piece it together in my mind. And then that's just a lesson to go to the next work. And you layer. I mean, all photographers, anyone who does anything artistically, they're always doing that as they practice whatever it is they do. They learn, they layer on, they learn from past experience. I've learned from a lot of things not working out. And a lot of people want to think of it as luck or chance. It's not. It's years and years of practice and doing it and paying attention to what's around you, what you hear, what you smell, what you touch.
Photo LA is an art fair attended by dealers and collectors who did not hesitate in buying some of the photographs presented by all 3 artists. Prices range between $300 and $1,000 or more.
I've liked underwater nudes and we wanted Brett Weston and could no longer afford a Brett Weston. And I really fell in love with this image.
The fact that Bruce is visually impaired, is this something interesting for you?
It's interesting. It's not the reason. We also have a John Dugdale photo and he's visually impaired. And so a great image is a great image.
Someone who's blind or has a disability can still do work at a level of Photo LA. Photo LA is one of the premier art shows in the United States, if not the world. And we believe that we can compete on a high level, but it's a high hurdle to jump over because many, many people have a lot of preconceptions about blindness. They can't get past the idea that how could a blind person take a picture?
Pete Eckert is one of the most famous blind artist photographers in the world. He works on light painting photography and was presenting some of his Playboy photographs.
Because I know you and I know your past work, I know it's Pete Eckert, but the first one that grabbed me is...
CSI TV series actor Robert David Hall, visiting the exhibition, met with Pete Eckert.
Other than taking pictures of Playboy models,
yeah,
one of the things I'm really excited about is there's a brand new product. It's new to the U.S., but it's been sold in Europe and in France especially. It's called Second Sight. It's an artificial retina. Now let that sink in, an artificial retina. My retina stopped functioning. The reason I can't integrate with the sighted world so well is my retina.
Is that something that would restore sight?
Dr. Mark Homayoun's artificial retina consists of a very small chip implanted into the brain, connected to a camera, fixed onto glasses, commanded from a small computer carried on a belt. The system developed by Second Sight has already been approved in Europe, but not yet in the US. The implant and the operation's cost is around $80,000, and Pete Eckert's intention is therefore to raise money selling his photographs in order to finance his operation.
I haven't seen my wife for 25 years.
It gives me a chill.
It's just fabulous. It's a miracle. And I'm bridge of tears in my own eyes.
For Pete Eckert, for Bruce Hall and Alice Wingwall, photography is not only an art, it has become an art of living and a way to see the world.